what to do if your application uses Microsoft Silverlight. Microsoft Silverlight is quickly becoming end of life. In this video, I want to address some of the alternatives you have for migrating off Silverlight and a few handy tips from us here at Flying Donkey to help you achieve that. Before we jump in, if you're new to the channel, please click the subscribe button below. We release plenty of content around building SaaS products and upgrading technology. And if you ever have a question around SaaS products or technology in general, feel free to post them below and I'm happy to address them in future videos. Without further ado, I'm Matt Grace, Managing Director of Flying Donkey. Let's get into it. What is Microsoft Silverlight? It seems a bit silly now to even run through this question because nearly a decade ago, Silverlight was in the pinnacle of its career. Adobe Flash was all the rage, but Silverlight was come in to save the day and make things far easier for people to develop interactive websites. Silverlight was used in huge productions, including NBC and Netflix applications. And today, while it's outdated and becoming end of life, previously it did a lot for the internet to move it forward. Silverlight has been getting dropped from support for the last 5 to 6 years. And in 2015 and 2016, major Silverlight users such as Netflix and Amazon already announced that they were removing Silverlight from the applications going forward because they could realize the way the world was going, and that is the use of HTML5 and single page applications. Why is Silverlight being deprecated? Well, simply put, it's been superseded by far superior technologies. And another way to put it is the last release for Silverlight was nearly a decade ago in 2011. Better and faster and easier to develop technologies in HTML5 and single page applications have superseded the need for Silverlight as a heavy framework. It simply makes no sense for Microsoft to support Silverlight anymore, and they made a decision nearly 10 years ago, and have now made it clear that Silverlight is no longer to be used on any web browsers. For me, the best time to drop support with Silverlight was really 10 years ago, but the second best time is to drop it now, and that's what's happening. What are the alternatives to Silverlight, and what can you replace it with in your application? Silverlight sits on the front end, so generally speaking, any of the modern technologies that use front end will be able to replace them, and we'll touch on them shortly. One of the ones you can look at is OpenSilver. OpenSilver is essentially Silverlight in a WebAssembly, and therefore can fairly easily replace Silverlight in your application. It will allow you to reuse a lot of Silverlight's code, but there is going to be some challenges in integration as it is slightly differently built. Alternatively, you can look at any of the newer front-end frameworks. Generally speaking, all of these are going to be HTML5 in nature. What you're going to have to do is migrate these Silverlight functionality into new HTML5 code. Essentially, the three main ones here are Blazor, React, and Angular. We'll quickly touch on Blazor. This is obviously a Microsoft product, and this is the one that's primarily recommended by Microsoft because it is their own product to transition off to. Blazor is the front-end language used in front of C# generally, and if you've got a C# application with Silverlight on front, it may make sense to use Blazor. Alternatively, two of the most popular front-end frameworks are Angular and React, and these single-page applications are super speedy and well-featured and can sit on top of any back-end. Generally speaking, here at Flying Donkey, we build most of our front-ends in React or Angular, as we find them to be the most feature-packed and well-supported, as both of them are backed by either Facebook or Google. Regardless of the technology you use, transitioning from Silverlight to a new technology is going to be a migration in itself. There is going to be a bunch of recoding, and one of the tips from us here at Flying Donkey is Silverlight probably forced you to do things a certain way back 5 to 10 years ago when you built the product for it. It's most probably worth the time to update your UI UX because essentially you are going to be rebuilding a lot of the components when you do put a new front end on your application. And what are my closing thoughts? As I mentioned, essentially migrating the front end from Silverlight is really going to be replacing it with a brand new front end framework. This is no small undertaking and it's going to take significant work for you to get through. At the same time, I highly recommend you look at UI UX design because if you're in there tinkering anyway, you may as well update the look and feel to make sure that you get some bang for buck out of the migration process. Here at Flying Donkey, we're experts in front-end development, and we can definitely help you migrate away from Silverlight. While at the same time, we can assist you upgrading your UI UX to modern standards and giving your users the best experience they can possibly have. This will allow you to potentially take a long-winded and cost-draining project and turn it into something positive that can really switch your application up a gear. All right, I hope this video has answered your questions about migrating Silverlight. Feel free to give this video a thumbs up if it has helped you. Alternatively, if you've got more questions, please add them in the comments below. Otherwise, if you'd like to discuss anything about upgrading your technology stack, including migrating Silverlight, please feel free to get in touch and we'd be happy to have a call.